What up? It's your boy, Luke Verprez, back in the mix yet again with another video for you guys. Hope everyone's doing great out there. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a Migos-type beat with the help of the brand new Captain Plugins Epic. So as usual, I like starting with the chords, so I'm going to go ahead and open up a brand new instance of Captain Chords Epic to get this thing rolling. And when it comes to Migos type beats, there's not necessarily a specific key that you have to stick to. I would say definitely something in the minor scale. I'm feeling D minor today, so that's what I'm gonna go with here. One thing that you can do to start is just start clicking this plus button here to start generating chords in the scale of D minor. And then as you hover over each chord that it generates, you can use this menu up here to actually change which chord it is and come up with a chord progression that way. Underneath each of these basic chords, you have a bunch of augmented chords that you could also throw into the mix just for some added variation. So that's a great way if you want to actually have like a completely blank slate to get things started and come up with something dope. Like, I just clicked in random things and let's see how it sounds. Right? So like, that's already dope. But today I'm gonna try something a little bit different. I'm actually not gonna go with a blank slate approach. I'm gonna see what I can find in the chord progressions that are already built in to the plugin. So in order to do that, you just click on top chords here, and then you can select from a bunch of different banks. Obviously, I'm gonna choose trap and hip hop for this one, and click best trap chords and see what it spits out. You can highlight everything and raise it an octave, which is what I'm gonna do because that sounded a little low to me. What you can also do is hit this little refresh button, and that's gonna bring up a brand new chord progression. So I'm gonna just cycle through some of these until I hear something that catches my ear. We're getting somewhere here. Let me raise this last one up. And then you can individually move the notes around as well, as you can see what I'm doing here. And the cool thing is it automatically will map each note to a key that's in the scale that you've selected. So in this case, D minor, obviously. So wherever you move anything, you can rest assured that it's gonna sound good with the rest of your composition. All right, so this is a good starting point. What I'm gonna do from here is play around with the timing of each chord so it's not just hitting on every beat like that. Cause you know, it's Migos typey. We gotta give it a little bounce, a little swing, you know what I mean? So you can actually highlight what you want and then just change the length of each chord here. Let's see what I can come up with. All right, so I've gone ahead and messed around with these chords a little bit. I've also added a bass note. I basically just highlighted all of these bottom notes and then copied them down an octave. You do that just by, you know, clicking and dragging here and then holding, at least on Mac, holding the option button, and then you can, boom, create a new one there. So that's what I did, but I'm gonna delete that. And yeah, so this is what I came up with the basic piano sound that I started with. Yeah. Simple, obviously, but it's got a little bounce. And by the way, today we're actually working in the BPM of 136. I would say the typical range for a Migos beat is anywhere from like 120 to 140. So as long as you're in that range roughly, you should be good to go. I'm pleased with how this is sounding. What I wanna do now is try to find a sound preset that more matches the vibe of the Migos. A lot of their music has kind of like vintage sounding bells, ambient pads as well, and also sometimes some kind of like ethnic sounding flutes. So I'm gonna try to incorporate some of those elements into this beat. And a good starting point is within the Captain Plugins Epic plugin itself. They have a big library of different sounds. Let's see what we can find in the bell category here. So there's a handy search feature at the top here. You can type in whatever you want and matching sounds will appear on the right-hand column. So let's cycle through some of these and see if any kind of match the vibe that I'm going for. Not exactly what I was looking for. Almost. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so like, that's pretty close to what I was envisioning. It's the Digital Magic Bells preset. Pretty dope. I'm gonna stick with that for now, but the cool thing is, if you ever do want to utilize something that's outside of the Captain Plugins Epic presets, it's really easy to do that. All you have to do is click this button here where it says Export MIDI, and then you can actually just drag it into your DAW and put it on any channel strip you want with any VST. So let's move on to a top melody. And to do that, I'm going to open up Captain Melody Epic, which automatically connects to whatever you previously made in Captain Chords Epic. So they work in perfect harmony together, if you will. And all you have to do to get something going is just click the plus sign, and it's gonna generate a top melody in the scale of D minor that's going to match the chords that you just made. So check this out. Like, that's dope already. It has kind of its own bounce going. I definitely want to change the preset. I'm going to try to find a flute sound, like I was saying. I think that's kind of a good fit for a Migos type beat. Let's see how that sounds. Okay, like, that's a dope sounding flute, honestly. Like, those are both really solid flutes. That's dope. I'm gonna just go ahead and click this little dice button here at the top. What that does is just randomize a new pattern for you that will appear and still automatically fit to what you previously made in Captain Chords. So let's see what the second one sounds like. That's an interesting bounce. I'm already so inspired to just kind of perfect this. It serves as like a really, really solid starting point, as you can hear. I'm gonna just cycle through a few more though. I love how this doesn't start right on the one. When I create my own counter melodies, I oftentimes will do that, again, just to add a little bit more bounce. So that's really cool to see. And then a new feature that you can utilize in this new Epic version of Captain Melody. So you can actually highlight individual notes that you like and then click this lock button. So if you want to have, you know, like the first five notes, like in this case, locked in, you can then continue to hit the randomize button and it's going to leave those in place, but then generate a new pattern around it, essentially, which is so dope. That's a dope starting point. So there's just like endless things that you can do. Let me just play around with this starting point and see what I can come up with here. All right, so after a lot of trial and error, I actually went kind of like a totally different direction, simplified it a little bit, and also changed the preset back to the original flute that I had tested. Here's what it sounds like by itself. That's pretty dope. And then here's what it sounds like in the context of the chords playing as well. So like, that's dope. I went ahead and EQ'd it, added a bit of reverb to it. Very happy with how that sounds. So I think I'm ready to put some drums on this thing, arrange it, and you know, see what we can come up with here. Boom. So I've come up with a very basic trap drum pattern. Try to give it a little bit of bounce without making it too busy and crazy. Here is what it sounds like. So from here, I'm just gonna arrange it, and I'm also gonna throw on Amigos acapella so you can hear what it would sound like if they were actually rapping on it. All right, so I've gone ahead and arranged this. I've added the acapella. The arrangement's pretty straightforward. The chorus is kind of the first thing that you'll hear, so that's the busiest part. It has all of the melody components playing at once, and then it goes into Quavo's first verse. So I kind of stripped everything down to just the chords and some of the drum components. You'll hear. With all that being said, I hope this video has been helpful. I hope you learned something and it's inspired you to give Captain Plugins Epic a try. It's crazy how quickly you can go from ground zero to a full beat with it. So I'm gonna play this beat now and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace. Straining, straining, yeah. Straining, 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 yeah. Don't not get straining but straining. Don't not get straining but straining. Don't not get straining but straining. You don't get shit straight, you don't straighten. In this game, sit back, be patient. Niggas act like the game went vacant. Niggas act like something been taken. What? Ain't nothing but a little bit of straightening. Been kicking shit, popping out daily. On the island, it's a movie I'm making. I'm kind of De Niro's with Robert De Niro. He telling them that you're amazing. Put that shit on. Nigga get shit on. I bought two whips and I put my bitch on. She put this wrist on. She fed the wrist, said it went rich and meal prone. Turn a pandemic into a pandemic. You know that's the shit that we on. Them niggas gon' pull up and L at the shit that's together. Won't fuck with you, home.